And welcome to this week's episode of 5 Minute Friday. I'm Miranda.
And I'm Dan.
And it's true, we are just winging it today. Longest week ever. All right, let's dive into our streaming gear. So we're streaming to YouTube and Facebook.
We're using vMix Pro version 22.
Got our PTZ Optics USB 20X camera.
Our X-Keys mouse mat, just holding up very well.
Yep, vMix Social on the Kindle Fire, so drop us some comments. And our X-Keys XKE124 T-Bar with the video switcher key set.
There we go.
There we go.
I do need to update that slide. Sorry, guys. But we've added an NDI camera from our good buddies at PTZ Optics. We're testing one of their NDI cameras.
Yep.
Maybe if we got time after R5's up, we might be able to show you a little bit of that.
Yeah. All right.
What are we doing today?
Today, we are going to talk about key blockers and masks.
Okay.
It's awesome. So let's go ahead over to our camera.
So over here, I've got an X-Keys torn apart so you can see what the guts are like. And, you know, we start with, at the top, we have these keycaps, right, with the lens on them that hold the legend on. Underneath that, there's this thing we call a key plunger, which the key attaches to. And this goes up and down in this thing that we call the key deck. And under here, we have an elastomeric membrane. Try saying that real fast 20 times. That sits on our PCB and makes contact when it gets depressed like this. So one thing we wanted to talk about today was when we customize these, you know, we have all kinds of large keys and different colored keys. And if you want to knock a key out to create a layout, we have this thing called the key blocker. And if you look, I don't know if this camera will focus on it. You know, pull back a little bit. You can see there's a post. There are two posts on this thing. And if you look very carefully in our key deck, there are holes for those posts to fit in. They do have an orientation. They're either upper left, lower right, or upper right, lower left, depending on the position in some of our devices. So you kind of have to pay attention to that when you're going to put a blocker in. Another thing is that if you just put this blocker on, the plunger has a tendency to try to push it back out. So what we recommend when you're installing these, and I've got an older unit right here, is that you take something like these needle nose pliers. Ooh, here we go. Jaws. And you grip the cross on this stem with your pliers and pull up. Yeah. It does take a little bit of force, but you're not going to break it. Just
it's very durable.
Grip it and pop it out. While I have this out, I want to show you something else. Could you give me a wider shot on this one?
Sure.
So in our X-Keys, the backlighting, it was designed just what we call it. It was designed for backlighting, not really key indication. And if you notice here on the blue one especially, and you see it better with the human eye than you do with this camera, we have an issue with what we call bleed over. So, you know, this is the only key that where the LED is on, but you can see that the ones around it kind of have that blue glow. And that's the way these were things were designed. It was supposed to be a general glow around the key. You can see the same thing with the red. But now that we have people using these for key indication, like vMix and some other softwares like that, one way we can kind of help that bleed over issue is with this mask. And so you take all the keys off and you lay this mask down in over the deck, and it kind of helps block the light from bleeding over. It doesn't completely eliminate it, but it does help it. If you're using it for key indication, makes it easier to see. And that creates other issues too. So if you're going to apply this blocker, now that we've taken this out, if you have the mask on and you try to force these posts through the mask, it's darn near impossible. So if you are going to install one of these over the mask, we suggest that you take a pointy object. I thought I had a pen around here, but I'm not finding it. Take a pointy object like a pen and find that hole and punch through the hole first. It's still hard to put the blocker in, but it's possible doing that. All right, at the post out, You just orient the post on the blocker, press it down.
Oh.
That's how you install it. Then we have variations on those, something we call a light pipe blocker. What this does is it lets you use that space, now that you don't have a key there, you could use it for indication by turning those LEDs on and off. And we are winging it, so I'm just going to try this here. Okay, there's my X keys, here's my key puller. Pop that out, grab the handy pliers here, and boink. And now, if I put this in there, you see that gives you a really bright glow. There's no doubt that that thing is on, and you're not so worried about the things around it.
Yeah.
And then you can orient these in one of two ways. If you put it with the LED down, with the light pipe down, then our red LED is going to come up through it. If you turn it around, well, we got a blue one right here, so let's try this. Right, let's do it out. And if we put this on the top, you got a nice clean blue. It looks nicer in here with my eye than it does on the camera. It's a nice blue glow. So we can do that. We have another one of those which has two pipes in it, so that if you install that, you can use the red LED for one indicator and the blue one above it for another one. All different variations that we have that allows you to customize your X keys and do fun stuff with it.
Yeah.
So.
Completely customize it. Make it whatever you want.
Yeah. So there's our quick tutorial. Let's get out here and then come back and talk to you guys.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
All right, we're back.
We are back. Before we do anything else, I have a PTZ control over here, and I will show you guys. Where is it? Oh, there it is. There it is, the backside of that NDI PTZ camera that we added
Very cool. To
the production. And, oh, now we're really lost, Miranda. So. Thought I had that preset set, but.
Bear with us.
Okay.
There we go.
And as part of that NDI test, I have that camera configured. Yeah, it's coming into our production via NDI, and vMix is talking back to it. So if you punch over to it real quick, like six. So these are presets in vMix which are set to different positions. So we go to seven. They're just set to different positions in the camera. So when you punch them up in, you normally we'd be punching them up in preview so you wouldn't see the camera moving around and refocusing and stuff.
Yeah.
But those positions for the PTZ are all set in vMix.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
All right. Do we have any questions?
What do we have here? I'm not really sure what that means.
Thumbs button. Thumbs up to like us, because you guys should.
You should. Did you get large blockers yet? Do you want to take that one?
We have a new thing coming. It's called our top surface, and it's kind of like large blockers in a sense. Mm-hmm. So you would do the same thing. You would take out, you'd send us how you'd want it cut, customized for your unit,
mm-hmm.
and then you would click it in there.
Yeah, we use our laser cutter to cut it precisely to fit on the X keys. So instead of having individual key blockers, you'd have one large surface that goes over everything.
Yeah.
It'll be pretty nice for those custom installs.
Absolutely.
Interesting.
There's someone here using an X key stick with a drone.
Drone.
That's cool.
Yeah, I hope you can capture some more information about that, Dedeker, and let us know.
Yeah. We always love pictures and videos.
Yeah. And what's this one? Can we get the blocker for X keys we already bought? Oh, yeah. Yeah, Jim.
Absolutely.
In fact, our if you punch over to our website for a second, they are available on our website under the accessories category. And you see blockers and light pipe blockers listed there. Yep. They come in packs of 10.
Packs 10, $6 a pack.
Yep. We also have that that mask available. It's not listed on the site yet.
It will be on the site very shortly.
If you want one in the meantime, email us, sales@xkeys.com, yep. and we can get one out to you. Ah. I believe we answered your question.
Knew you were going to ask it.
Yeah, and we have the masks in sizes for the XK24 and for the 80, and then for the T-bar.
Yep.
Or you can always get multiples and overlap them to fit whatever you need to fit.
Yep.
Let's see, any more questions in here? Just fun comments.
Yep. And another trick with the mask, because personally I have a hard time poking the holes to get the blockers through it, you can always cut it. Cut it to the shape of your layout of where the blockers are and save it and then put it in. You know, if you want to rekey those spots up, you right. can always put the mask back in there.
That is very true. It's fun with scissors and paper.
I mean, arts and crafts.
I should probably read these comments before I put them up in case something's dangerous here. But
even one button, that'd be
great. One view. Yes. One giant button that you can't miss. And yes, we do read minds. Some people say we're psycho, psychic. It's a fine line. If I see him, I'll ask the man with the drone about the X keys. He was chasing a train here, like the rest of us. Oh, okay.
Nice.
Yeah, that would be interesting. As you know, Dedekuru, they're all over the place doing all kinds of things, and we're always interested in hearing what's happening out there. Here's a new one, Big Shoe. Are you chasing the 4014? We'll see what comes back from that. Tommy, you would probably need training for that one giant button on the X keys. We can provide that. We can help you out there.
Yep.
So, more questions?
Questions, comments?
You know, Miranda, I was yakking with somebody over email the other day and realized that we are coming up on the anniversary of our first show.
No way. It hasn't been that long.
June, I want to say 25th or something like that of last year.
That sounds right. Wow. So, we'll have to do something special for that.
All right. Oh, here's our answer. Okay. The drama is unfolding here. I wonder how Big Shoe knew about that train and what is going on, who Big Shoe is and what's going on. It's just a mystery.
All right.
So we'll have to start thinking about something cool and special to do.
Absolutely.
Further for our anniversary show.
Oh, I can't believe it's coming up that quick.
Yeah.
Or that we've done that many shows.
Hey, Maggie liked her video. Yep.
Yay.
Yeah, maybe I can refine that a little bit, Maggie, and we can get it up on our website and our Amazon listing so we can help those people out.
Yeah.
Well, I don't see any more questions or any more information about that train coming in. I hope that he caught it.
Well. All right. Well, I think it's time to go back to work.
Okay. Happy Friday, everybody.
Happy
Thanks
Friday.
For watching, and we'll see you next week.
See you next week.
Bye.
Bye.